Hi,
I'm
Kevin,
and
I'm
Grace,
and
we're
the stories. We are comparing Kenyan and American culture to see what's different, but also what's similar.
Ha! Today,
we
are
talking
about...
Today, we're going to give a quick five-tip guide for Kenyans who want to come and visit New York City.
Yes. Tip number one is come prepared, because the weather here is very volatile.
Volatile.
It changes like the stock market.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Of course, I grew up around here, so it's not very different for me. We have talked about the weather in our episodes before, but if you're coming to New York, you want to spend some time here, you're going to put a little planning into when you're coming, because some months of the year are very cold, some months of the year are very hot and humid, and the months in between are pretty nice. I mean, depending on what you're after. So December, January, February, those are winter months. That's going to be cold, probably temperatures around 0 degrees Celsius. So then March, April, May, those are your spring months. And when you're getting into May, it starts to warm up. And I think May might be my favorite month.
Because it's my birthday.
Then June, July, August, those are your summer months. Pretty hot. It's going to be humid. And then September, October, November, that's getting into fall. Now, September can tend to be hot still. And it's really in October when you're going to feel that temperature really drop going into November. So that's something to keep in mind. It rains all the time. By that, I don't mean it's raining all the time. What I mean is it doesn't matter what season. There's always the chance of rain. Hurricane season is something that you may have to worry about, which is when a big storm comes up the east coast of the United States. That's generally September, October. In the winter, it can snow.
I hate snow, so.
So you're going to want to bundle up if you come in the winter months. But I have to say, New York City in December, it's all decorated for Christmas. There's a big Christmas tree. You can go ice skating.
Oh my God.
A certain someone I know went ice skating for the first and possibly last time ever.
Yes,
a few,
that's true.
A few Christmases ago.
Yeah. So tip number two, come with money.
Come with money.
Things are expensive here in New York specifically. Like, you know, you have to budget, have a good budget. Food, for example, is very cheap in Kenya, as you've seen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, here it's probably twice, even three times the price, at times even 10 times the price. You
it
know?
Can be, it can be. So
yeah.
If you're coming to visit, you're more likely than not going to eat out maybe three meals a day.
Yes.
That's going to be expensive. Your breakfast, I mean, you can get cheap options here and there. You could pay as little as $3 for breakfast, I guess. It depends on what you're eating. But if you're going to eat a full something every meal, you're probably going to spend $50 a day.
Yes. Yeah. And that's a lot, you know.
Yeah. That's 5,000 Kenyan shillings a day. That's
a lot.
I mean, you probably don't want to go through that. But if you're staying in an Airbnb, somewhere with a kitchen, it may be cheaper to try and buy groceries and cook for yourself. But I do think you should definitely explore the restaurants in New York.
Yes.
They're so good. And you can definitely find some good options that are not too expensive. Chinese food, bagels. Gotta have
pizza,
a bagel. Pizza. Dollar pizza. So it only takes 99 shillings to buy a slice of pizza. But on the other hand, you were saying that there's certain things that you would buy here that you wouldn't necessarily buy in Kenya.
Yeah, so things like gadgets, even clothes. You know, if you find... I know someone who would buy H&M clothes and go and sell them in Kenya, and they'd sell it at three times the price.
Mm.
So, you know, buying such things are better here
okay.
than in Kenya.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So you're prepared to pay more maybe for food, for transportation, that kind of thing. But you can get a good deal on...
gadgets and clothes.
Goods and
Yeah.
All right, what's our third tip?
Where to stay.
Oh, this is a good one. I'm just going to take this one.
Okay.
There are a lot of options for places to stay in New York City. And you're going to find a lot of cheap ones. But those cheap places are either going to be very far away from where you want to be, or they're going to be places that you wouldn't normally want to stay in.
Mm-hmm.
Or they could even turn out, as you found out recently with your mother, they can turn out to be scams. So,
yes.
So you want to really be sure that you're finding a good place. Don't stay near the airport. There's lots of hotels near the airports, and there's just they're so far away from anything you want to do. You can get Airbnbs in New York, and they range in prices.
Yeah.
You may find that there are hotels that are doing deals, but make sure you're looking for hotels that are close to where you want to be. Mm. So find places in Manhattan. They don't have to be in Times Square. They don't have to be in those areas. You can get an Airbnb in Chelsea or in Harlem or in other areas because it's easy to move around the city. But you don't want to be so far away that it takes half the day just to get to where you want to go. Okay, so keep that in mind. Anywhere in Manhattan is generally good. Even the South Bronx, downtown Brooklyn, that area is okay. Long Island City, Astoria, also fine. There's no reason to go to Staten Island.
You can go to New Jersey, though.
I don't know. I don't know if I would do New Jersey, but...
Hoboken is just one stop in Manhattan.
Yeah, I know. But then there's the path, and it's a whole other thing, and blah, blah, blah. All right, yes, you could stay in New Jersey, but be prepared for it to be a thing. You have to I think you have to know what you're doing.
Yeah.
Much more if you're going to try to come from New Jersey to here.
That's true.
I would say stick to Manhattan. If you're here for a visit. No, if you're here for a visit, like just to experience, to explore, like I would say come to Manhattan because it's going to be easier to do the things you want to do.
Right.
What is tip number 4?
Keeping time.
Keeping time. So like I'm a musician and I'm playing and I've got to make sure I keep time.
No. So Kenyans are known of being late to everything. There's actually a phrase for it, Kenyan time. When explaining something to someone, like when I was explaining to your family in Kenya, I would say 7 o'clock Kenyan time or 7 o'clock. That's an example. So you say Kenyan time. So then they know like, oh, expect me to be late.
Mm.
Yeah. So we have a weakness of not keeping time.
In Kenya.
In Kenya.
So when you come here for a visit, what are you suggesting?
You want to keep time or else you might end up being in trouble. You know, if you're having an interview, for example, or meeting someone, you don't want to be late. They'll be angry at you, first of all, and you'll miss out on opportunities if there are any. So.
Sure. And yes. New Yorkers are they're fast and efficient. You know, they want to get things quickly. Even if you go to a deli and order some food, they're going to want you to order quickly in a timely fashion. It's not like they want you to be there at a certain time.
Yes.
But don't wander off. Don't go and find the chips or something. You got to wait. And they're going to throw that sandwich at you. You got to be ready.
Yes.
This is also true if you make a reservation at a restaurant or if you're going to go to the Empire State Building or the Freedom Tower, you're going to go up to the top. They have time slots, so you have to make that time slot or else you can forfeit your ticket or your reservation. So make sure you're on time for that. Even being 15 minutes late is sometimes too late.
Yes.
But hopefully within that, you can find your times to just be free. I mean, there's no schedule for Central Park. You can always go and walk around.
Next is getting around.
Getting around.
Yeah.
Would you say that New York City is easy to get around?
It is compared to Kenya where you're stuck in traffic for hours. It's different here. There's so many modes of transport as you'll explain now.
Well, okay, I guess I'm on. The New York City subway is, in my opinion, the best way to get around New York City.
Mm-hmm.
It's underground. It's not beholden to any kind of above ground traffic. Mm-hmm. Usually, the subway runs 24 hours. Currently, due to COVID-19, there is a gap in the evening, I guess early morning hours, when there's no subway. But hopefully that will change soon, and I can edit this part out of the video. But until then, just be aware of that the trains will stop at a certain time. But generally, they run 24 hours. You can get a subway anytime. So that's another reason why it's good to have your accommodations be in Manhattan, so that you're close to those subway lines. Now, there are some places where the subway doesn't go. For example, if you wanted to visit the Bronx Zoo. I don't know why, if you're coming from Kenya, you want to go see animals in a zoo.
There's some animals, like penguins, which
Sure.
Kenyan probably as, or bears and.
Sure, yeah. Sure. But in order to get the Bronx Zoo, you can't take a train directly. You kind of have to, you can take a train to the bus or a subway to the bus. So that's something.
And sloths.
Yeah. There's sloths there as well. Oh, good. So you may need to take a bus for some reason. Also, there are no subways that cross Central Park. So you can take a bus for that if you'd like to, which is a kind of nice, neat way to get from one side of the city to the other if you're above a certain level. The subway and the bus both can be confusing. I think Google does a pretty good job of telling you what trains you should take, what stop you should get off. Mm-hmm. There's also an MTA app, which is the subway and all the transit, New York City transit, is in an app. You can also use that. And of course, there are cabs. There are Ubers. All of those kinds of things.
Bicycles.
There are city bikes if you want to bike around the city. I recommend it. It's not too bad. The subways and the buses cost currently $2.75 mm-hmm. to ride. But you get as many transfers as you want within that, pretty much. So if you go from the subway to the bus, you won't pay for that, mm-hmm. which is nice. Mm-hmm. The city bike, I think, is $3 for a single ride. But you can get a day pass. You can ride unlimited for a day if you want to. And I think biking around the city is a lot of fun. Just be careful because drivers can be pretty obnoxious.
Yeah.
And walking. Honestly, you can just walk around the city. I can't tell you how many times I've walked from like 110th Street down to 14th Street or whatever. That's
a lot.
Yeah. But you can get lost in it. You can really walk. We've walked a lot around the city.
Yeah.
Do you have anything else to add? Any final notes on visiting New York City?
Just come expecting diversity and everything. People, food, weather.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a fun place to be.
Yeah. And if you're coming to New York City for a visit, let us know. Drop a comment down below or find us on social media. I mean, you know, maybe we can help you out or something. If you've visited New York before, or maybe you're a New Yorker watching this video, do we leave something out? Is there something you want to know more about? Let us know all of that. Maybe we can make another one of these videos if it's of interest. I was told that we should get Grace to do New York accent. So thank you as always to the members of my Patreon. You're helping to make this and other videos possible. Until next time, Kwa Heri.
Bye.
While others may be rich of pocket, we are rich of heart.